I can assure you that you'll be proud of our young people in the classroom, in the community.
Those five players, they know what they did, and they brought this university down.
Jim Tressel has decided to resign.
They ruined a university.
He screwed up monumentally because he needed to win the national championship.
Not the end of Ohio State football.
You have to hire the right coach.
Let me introduce to you our head football coach, Urban Meyer.
I followed the Buckeyes as far back as I can remember. You know, it's where I'm from. I had a great childhood where football was so important. You weren't a fan, it wasn't a team, it was a way of life. That was really all you knew. Obviously, there's been a couple speed bumps along the way that we have to get everything back in order. All I think about is the responsibility.
Oh, don't you worry. You'll find yourself. Follow your heart. And nothing else.
After I left Florida, I thought I was done.
Go, hurry up, go. Be a badass, be a badass. Oh, oh, oh! Gosh, I love this game. Isn't this a great game? It's so easy to be average. It takes a little something special to be a great player. We're gonna push your ass like it's never been pushed. Break it down, let's go! Hey, Skip 20!
This is Mickey Marotti. Today, this is his Ohio State team.
The hell we doing? Focus over there.
But tonight, after this last sweat-soaked workout session of the summer, will belong to Urban Meyer.
Don't reach, run! Higher, higher! You had to have great willingness to do what we're asking you to do. More steps! Do it right!
Marotti's official title is Assistant Director for Football Sports Performance. But in reality, he is a drill instructor, a dictator, a muscled-up mini-Meyer.
I need a guy that's going to be with him, that's going to break him down but love him up, that's going to give him confidence but also make sure it's real confidence, not fake confidence.
Quick, Jeff, that's too slow.
I don't know if I've ever trusted anybody as much as him.
Come on, Tommy. Football starts tomorrow, Tommy.
Ohio State is a place of tradition. Woody Hayes, 7 Heisman trophies, the annual football war against Michigan.
Third group!
And now, there's a handoff when Marotti officially presents his newly conditioned team to Meyer.
Shake him out, shake him out. Tonight's championship banquet, it's kind of a symbolic day where we basically give the team to Coach Meyer. I'll stand him up, I'll look him right in the eye. I might have a tear or two. It means a lot to me, it means a lot to us. We put a lot of time into you guys.
Let's go, family, on 3, 1, 2, 3.
I actually started this back at Bowling Green. It really took off, though, when Coach Mick became our strength coach, and we made it almost like a celebration. From they're done running, they're done training, now it's time for them to do what they love to do, play a little football.
Well, on behalf of the strength staff, the performance team, the trainers, the nutritionists, the team, Coach Meyer, I want to give you your 2012 Ohio State Buckeye football team.
When I was hired in December, I promised you we had a plan. Remember that? We talked about a plan? The plan was infallible. Part of that infallible plan is getting a team prepared, ready to go, so when we start practice, our coaches know what we got. At the end of the day, when you walk in the locker room, 60 minutes of football, there's a winner and a loser. There's a champion and a non-champion. You're the Ohio State Buckeyes. You're an angry football team. You got an angry staff. You got a bunch of guys that are getting ready to start a journey. You're a hungry football team, and I'm proud to be your coach.
Urban Meyer was born and raised in Ohio, but it was at the University of Florida where he became arguably the best coach in the country.
The Florida Gators have won another BCS National Championship, their second in the last 3 years.
I don't know how you could roll out of a scandal any better than Ohio State has rolled out of this one. I mean, not only did they hire a man who's won two national championships, but the guy's a native son.
When you just look at what he's been able to accomplish throughout his career, I think he's uniquely prepared to lead our program. I told him and I told his wife, I'd be very committed to make sure he achieved balance because I think that's so important, and he had lost balance.
In his final seasons at Florida, Meyer lost that balance because of his pursuit of perfection.
It just consumed him. It ultimately led to him not taking care of himself, you know, not eating, not sleeping.
His 2009 Florida team was 12-0 and still in the hunt to win back-to-back national titles when it faced Alabama in the SEC championship.
Touchdown, Alabama!
The Gators lost by 19.
My job became so much more important than anything else because of the chase, you know, the chase of perfection. It was trying to do something that's never been done there.
The defeat overwhelmed Meyer. In the wee hours after the loss, he suffered stress-related chest pains and was rushed to the hospital.
My initial reaction was, really? Is this job really killing him?
It wasn't a heart attack, but it was a wake-up call. Meyer took a leave of absence and resigned for good after the 2010 season.
I remember experiencing just like relief. Like, as a family, we were just like, oh my God, like, we made it through it, and that's it.
January 2nd, he was done with coaching. Sometime in February, he told me he had to go back, that he missed it so bad. Less than 2 months.
I felt I made a mistake leaving Florida. You know, I told my wife, I said, I got a problem here. And someday I'm gonna have to go back.
But before he could return to coaching and Ohio State, he first had to convince his family he was a changed man.
He looked at me in the eyes and he was like, I swear, like, things are gonna be okay. Like, things are gonna work. And that's when I wrote that contract.
Meyer's oldest daughter, Nikki, wrote the contract on a sheet of pink notebook paper. 10 promises, non-negotiable. If he didn't sign it, he couldn't coach again.
My family will always come first. I'll take care of myself and maintain good health. I will continue to communicate with my kids daily.
I lost it a little bit. You know, obviously, there's a lot of tears in the room. It hit home, but I was so proud of her.
He read the contract, and he had to sign it before he took the job, and he did sign it.
He's going to stick to this promise, and he's putting us first. And I absolutely know that now, and it just feels really good.
It's a new day. It's a new day.
Players. The hell with that! Ooh, ooh!
You gotta go hard, hard, hard! Really freaking hard!
Run! Here come the bullets!
I don't need a whole lot of rah-rah. We're all good to go. We're all good to go. It's our first day. No big deal. First day as a Buckeyes. 2012 Buckeyes. No big deal about rah-rah. You're not impressing anybody. You want to really impress someone? Go +2 and finish your drills. +2 means you're going 2 steps beyond what's asked of you. Train your eyes up here. If you want to do that, I'm here to tell you that's going to help you to win. I'm going to watch that real close. So +2 and finish is what I want today. Let's have a little fun. What the hell, Rowdy? Let's have a little fun.
Time to go. It's good work now.
Listen up. Take the field like you own it.
Speed, speed, eyes. You and I are about to fight right now. Who's gonna get the first punch in? Me or you?
You!
So why are you winding up way back here and you got a linebacker coming 100 miles an hour to block your quarterback? Here's what I said. Go again.
Get off that! Get off that!
We made a commitment day one that our tempo was gonna be flawless, correct?
Vertical, man. You gotta go run right by him.
You're gonna get cut. You're gonna get blocked. You gotta think and you gotta hustle when you're tired. You gotta go hard, 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 really freaking hard.
Gosh, I love this game. Isn't this a great game? So freaking easy. That's what makes it so damn hard.
Urban Meyer's spread offense has a jaw-dropping history of success. His teams have scored 40 or more points in almost half of his 104 career wins.
The offense that Coach Meyer brought in is very fast-paced.
Quickly, go, call it. Too slow, Matt, we're too slow.
They're throwing the ball everywhere, they're running the ball everywhere.
Yeah, stick it in there this time, fast throw.
It's something different that Ohio State fans aren't really used to.
Spread offense is based off numbers, so you have the defense spread out.
Let it go, rip it. Atta boy.
It's gonna create lanes for receivers, for backs, for quarterbacks.
You gotta be a grown-ass man to throw this one. Not sure we got any grown-ass men in their black shirts today.
Man, I love it. Fire wide. In the backfield by myself and five guys blocking for me, so this is a lot of playmakers on the field, just gotta get the ball to them.
When the first team takes the field, people ought to take notice.
But there's a difference between learning an offense and actually mastering it.
Oh, no. You just fumble the ball, man. Why not play this year, huh?
Come on, get your mind right. Let's go.
Game rep. That's a bad rep. Watch this. Oh, right here. Boom.
Go, oh, catch the ball first, right?
Took your eyes off the ball. Took your eyes off the ball.
We just dropped the ball. You had a first down.
Go, get out of there. Get out. This ain't grammar school. We got to go. Here's my evaluation for the day. It's so easy to be average. You know it as well as I know it. You just practiced and it's first day, cheering and all that kind of stuff, and I still saw average. It takes a little something to be special, Don. It takes a little something special to be a great player. We don't have enough great players. To hell with that! We don't want to coach average. I don't want to be around you. Why be around average? Did you push yourself to be great today? Did you do it? If you didn't do it, you lost today. We ain't got many days to lose. We're going to push your ass like it's never been pushed. Because what you got in you, we're going to find out. Kenny, I'm going to find out. And if there's a touch of greatness in there, how cool would that be? Let's go with John Simon. Break it down. Let's go.
Let's go, family. On three, one, two, three. Family.
Meyer is big on team unity, especially this year as the Buckeyes deal with an NCAA postseason ban. That's where his longtime Big Brother program will help.
Once your Big Brother takes that stripe off, you're a Buckeye now.
A black stripe represents a freshman who has not become a Buckeye yet.
It's kind of a ceremonial thing. You know, you get in front of the team, the coach will say, you know, this guy's done a great job.
He's no longer a freshman. We don't consider him a freshman. It's like watching your son graduate or something like that.
Started this about 11 years ago. It's called the Big Brother Program. For every newcomer that step foot on this campus, if you notice when you put on your helmet, you got a black tape on it. That means you're different than everyone else. You have to earn your right to be on this team. Until then, I've had guys wear black stripes for about a year and a half. I hope it doesn't happen here. Get your black stripe off. Coach Drain's gonna pop up here and he's gonna sign your Big Brother. You guys ready to go? All right, Stan Drain, here you go. Let's go, man. Let's go, man.
It's one of those traditions that you're gonna have fun with. You'll be able to tell this story a long time. And I'm gonna call your name, freshman, your little rookie, your little soft, newcoming guy who don't know you don't know. You don't even know you don't know. I'm gonna introduce him to you, and I'm gonna call his big brother up for the newcomer. I am gonna give you your big brother's nickname, okay? And you have to call him by his nickname the entire camp. Cardell Jones, get up here, let's go. On the hop, clap it up for him. You know he don't have a damn clue, right? Okay, I'm gonna introduce your big brother. You gotta come down here, show him some love. Braxton Jerry Curl Miller. Let's go. Come on, Braxton. What's his nickname?
Jerry Curl.
Jerry Curl, that's it, let's go. Kareem Stevens, come on down, hurry up, Kareem. His big brother will be Will Meaty Neck McCrary. Come here, Will. Hey, Will, come here, Will. Come here, Will. Come here, man. Let me see. Turn around, man. Let me see that, man. How do you get body fat off a neck? I don't know. Devin Bogard. Devin, let's go. Hurry up, Devin. Actually, you got to be patient here, okay, Devin? I got two nicknames for your big brother. You got to remember two here, okay? Your big brother will be Orion Flavor Flav Johnson or Orion Short Ass Braids Johnson. In all seriousness, take care of each other, all right? When you see them hitting the wall, you be there for them. You guys got that? All right, guys, thank you.
On the morning of day two, There are 17 players who have more to worry about than just football. They have summer school and their biology final.
Look at all this stuff. Ridiculous.
I'm trying to get my last cramming in before I go take it.
The last test, and then it's all camp.
Game day. Either 0-1 or you 1-0. I'm going here to try to be 1-0.
Step up and knock this out, and then all we gotta worry about is football for a little while.
All in today! Get a little harder on day two! First, you're late off the ball! Soft guys don't play! Be a playmaker! You gotta get this one real hard for two steps! Bring the juice!
Get juiced up, here we go.
You got the juice?
Juice is a well-known word around this program.
Robe ain't got no juice today, Robe.
Hey, Marcus, anybody can have juice one day.
Juice, it's like energy, excitement.
You gotta get the juice!
You gotta be pumped, you know what I'm saying? You gotta have energy at all times. I just wanna do it. That's for a little juice.
Juice runs in your blood. You either have it or you don't.
No juice today. You're just addicted. When somebody say juice, it's like the whole team gonna say juice. We're gonna go circle here in 30 seconds. I want some juice now. Let's go.
Circle drill really changes the intensity of practice, head on head.
Mano y mano.
One on one. It's kind of a tone setter. It's kind of like a bull in the ring.
The adrenaline starts going through your body.
Two guys will get down in 3-point stance, so go head to head.
You're able to tell who the man and who the boys are.
Whoever pushes the other guy back wins.
You don't want to lose, especially in front of coach.
War and ball!
That's a fight or flight mentality that tells me you're in front of your guys. You better stand up and hold your ground.
It's a winner and it's a loser. There's no gray area.
All right, here we go. Bring it up, let's go. Bring it up real fast. Next. I'm going to have John Simon break him down.
Go family on 3, 1, 2, 3. Family.
Senior running back Jordan Hall was supposed to be one of the centerpieces of Meyer's spread offense. That was before he stepped on a piece of glass in late June and tore a tendon in his right foot.
I go see the doc, see what's up with my foot. Hopefully it's good news.
Jordan Hall means a lot to this team. He brings so much to the offense. It kind of sucks not having him in camp.
He's a big part of this team. We can't wait to get him back, get him going with us again.
How you doing?
All of us were kind of, you know, a little shocked, you know, when he got injured. It's really gonna hurt the first couple weeks when he's out.
When you cut that tendon, we repaired that, but it's a slow healing structure. It can take a minimum of 8 weeks until it has enough strength that you can put any force on that. It can take up to 3 months or 12 weeks until you really can push off on it the way you want to.
Go.
He's 6 weeks from his surgery. About halfway through the whole healing process, there's enough healing that has happened inside the tendon and in his foot that we can allow him to bend it. And I'd say over the next week, we can allow him to start putting just a little bit of resistance on it.
Phase two of Camp Painful begins as all 104 players move into their temporary home.
And now I'm just packing up. We got 2 weeks of camp. It's just a big team thing. Everybody going to the hotel, staying in the same place.
When you're in a hotel together, everyone gets closer. I mean, just being around each other 24/7, it really creates a brotherhood.
Just came to the hotel where we're gonna be locked down for the next 9 or 10 days.
Hopefully, y'all is home for the next 2 weeks. Deal with this. Running water? Can't complain.
Well, I hope I get a good roommate. I always have to do this when I first get in the hotel room. Oh yeah. This is gonna be nice right here.
We got a chug contest. Just everybody's gonna open up a Gatorade. When I say go, nail it. Quarterbacks. Here we go.
As soon as you hear that knock, you know what it is.
Not yet. What? We got competition. Full Gatorade in front of your desk. Where's the full Gatorade? Put your hands behind your back. Put your hands behind your back, Roby.
Let's make it on. All right, chug.
Ready, set, go, go! Chug it, chug it. Uh-oh, go, go! You had no airflow. There's no airflow in there. No airflow.
Nice Gatorade come out my nose.
It's a fun way to get the guys to drink and get some fluid in them. Keep going, finish it! Finish it!
Just making sure everyone's hydrated and healthy for practice.
Uh-oh. Winner, burger.
Right, there it is.
Chug it!
Braxton is horrible at chugging his Gatorade. He just laughs the whole time.
That was awful. Miller, awful. I'm embarrassed for you.
Honestly, I'm not good at chugging. I'm more worried about trying not to have all the Gatorade spill on me.
Forced into the starting lineup as a true freshman, Braxton Miller led the Buckeyes in passing and rushing. Now he must prove he can lead a team.
Much better day yesterday for Braxton. He was there, he was engaged, he was actually patting people on the butt and running around.
To play quarterback, you gotta get everyone playing for you. You're the center of that offense, and we're not there yet.
Yeah, mechanically, he's a little self-conscious right now, so we gotta just get him back into something that's comfortable and live with what he is.
Right now, he's an athlete playing quarterback. You know, I'd say last year he's an athlete taking a snap. He's really doing a nice job learning.
Let's go.
Have a good day, bro. Leadership.
We're gonna get good practice in today, right? We're gonna get 2 good hours today. I mean, like, really good hours today. Who pulls you through, coaches or leaders? Leaders, 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 right?
Yes, sir.
Pull through a quarterback. Quicker reaction, complete it. Real hard, Braxton, real hard, sell this. That's it. Got him.
We're not intense, they're playing harder than us, they're playing faster than us, don't think, play!
1, 2, 3.
Offense.
See if these guys got to have a little bit of fun on defense.
Green 50, 12
deuce
book.
Left, left,
green
left.
Dunk right, 12
green
book.
7 stage.
Got a boy.
Braxton Miller's sight to see, man. He's nice. He's running the ball. He's going to make somebody miss. He's going to make something happen.
Go get one.
Best way I could describe him is a joystick, to be honest, because some of the stuff that he does at will is just, it's really ridiculous.
He's arguably the finest athlete I've coached at quarterback.
Good job. Why aren't you accelerating? Fat ass, you're going. The only team in America with overweight quarterback. Hey. Big ass. Real big. I didn't realize it was that big. Nasty, too. I mean, nasty. Yeah. We failed our first 2 minutes because we didn't quite understand the urgency. Braxton, don't wait. Snap the ball. We're in a panic here, right?
Two things. Why didn't you take the guy in the flat?
Who?
No one near him.
He was? You put your life on it?
We're probably a little bit ahead of other places we've been because the athleticism at quarterback. At times, it doesn't look very good, but I'm also blowing the whistle every time the quarterback runs. You know, if I don't blow that whistle, some of those 1 or 2 yard gains are big hits. So we'll unleash it on September 1st.
Devin, how's mom doing?
She's doing better.
You know what, some night, let's me and you call her.
All right.
Some night, remind me. Mm-hmm. Just some night, you know, because we're gonna be meeting a lot here pretty soon, a lot at night.
Yeah.
Just remind me, say, let's call my mom.
Devin's unique. I mean, what he's gone through is to most people, you know, unbelievable. An incredible family, very difficult situation, and a guy that is so committed to Ohio State and his teammates that he's just, I enjoy being around him every second of the day. I could hang out with Devin Bogart.
All right, let's go with Big Brother. When I say Big Brother, that means someone is one of us after tonight. Someone is going to get their black stripe removed. Someone might be, maybe that's been their dream, to be Ohio State Buckeye, major college football player. That dream is going to be done tonight. All right, stand straight, there we go.
You guys heard it, all right? This is a major deal here. He's overcoming so much adversity right now in his life. It's incredible. He just lost a very close loved one of his, a sibling. You wouldn't even know it because when the whistle blows out in that football field, guys, all he does is just go from point A to point B as fast as he can go. And I love this young man, and I'm proud to present to you a member of your football team, Devin Bogart. Big brother, you take the stripe off while he's doing that, all right?
No doubt. What are you talking about, overcome adversity? I lost my oldest brother to cancer. I mean, it was hard, but sometimes I think about him sometimes, but I got all y'all. And I look up to all y'all. Carlos ran me over today, but it's cool. I'm giving him all. So I love y'all. We're going to get this little undefeated season on it this year. So let's get it.
No doubt. You know, you never really know what somebody's going through. Devin just carries himself real well. He goes through a lot of stuff. It was a real good feeling just being able to get my little brother to be the first Buckeye part of this team from his freshman class.
After an emotional meeting, Meyer heads to the team hotel, where he'll spend the next 10 nights with his players.
I don't know where the hotel's at.
I texted you the address.
So I just punch it in. Yeah. You guys know where the hotel's at? How you doing? Yes, how was that? I started packing a suitcase and my wife said, what are you doing? I said, I'm going away. So I bring a toothbrush, toothpaste, maybe a razor, probably not. 48 years old. What do? I go stay in a hotel. What else you do? Just coach a little bit and stay in a hotel. What I really love about that is that, you know, within the next 5, 6, 7 days, all the shields will be down. You'll have a broken, you know, just a bunch of broken guys, broken coaches, exhausted, and you have to rely on each other. I mean, or you're done.
Get your rest. Good day tomorrow.
Well, this is such a great rivalry. The Wolverines knock off the Buckeyes.
To beat Michigan.
Party Columbus.
Best rivalry in all of football.
For the Buckeyes, the winning streak is alive.
At Ohio State, you're measured by that game. You can go 11-1, and if you lose to Michigan, it's a bad year.
We really don't like each other.
You said Michigan, my stomach hurts.
They don't say our name, we don't say theirs.
We refer to them as the team up north.
The hatred for each other is just, you won't even say the other team's name.
Playing against the team up north is the most physical game that I've ever been a part of.
It's a whole different mindset. It's like you have no friends out there.
Last year's game.
Michigan finally beats Ohio State.
Losing on their field, that ain't gonna happen again.
Countdown clock counts down how many days, hours, seconds till Michigan.
That game is everything as it is, but with no bowl game, it's even more.
That's our Super Bowl.
You have to win that game.
You have a whole state that you're fighting for.
It's a whole other game. It's the game.
Hurry up, man. Head downstairs.
Better get up, Chris.
The bus is leaving soon.
You gotta go right now?
Yeah, get dressed and go right now. What you think? You think you just get up and just chill in the room?
Early practice. Real early.
You wake up in the morning, you sore.
Gotta go.
That quick turnaround, it's tough.
Feel like you're not getting much rest at all. But you know, it's also fun because you're doing what you like to do every day. Day in, day out, it's all football.
They were told to head back to the Woody Hayes Athletic Center.
Any chance after we're stretching all that we should go outside?
There's lightning strikes that could pop up, so there's a good chance of another cell coming.
Okay. Let's make sure. Good teams adapt, right? A little weather, we adapted, we're inside, gotta go, don't matter. Put the ball down, let's play.
Football here.
You got the ball down here, you gotta score.
Put your face on him.
Go get it, go get it.
It's a drill! It's a freaking drill!
That's fun right there. In case you wonder what fun is, that's fun.
D9 on 3, 1, 2, 3.
All right, Simon, get him going. Simon, make a play. Make a play. Win a game.
Nobody on the roster plays harder or leads harder than senior defensive end John Simon.
John Simon's a beast, he's a dog. Good luck trying to block him.
Whack job. Crazy. I mean, there's really no other guy on this team or in this country that I know of who got a motor like him.
Good, John. Hell yeah.
On the field, he's unstoppable. He's pretty much a wrecking ball.
Wake up. You look like shit.
He's a leader. He's always out there going hard, giving 110%. So you have no choice but to follow or get out.
He's going to be right here. You're going to down block, and he's just going to go like this and kill him. Hold him. Hold him. Go, go, go. Hey, that's it, Stevie.
He's one of the unique ones. You know, I've had some, I mean, my list of players that I've been able to be around is incredible. He has to be one of the top three, four guys I've ever been around. Only the complete certifiably nut jobs like Tim Tebow and John Simons like enjoy 2-a-days. It's just impeccable character, honesty, integrity, but then a work ethic that, I mean, just unchallenged work ethic. Just that's all he knows is to go.
Health problems in 2009 had a lot to do with Meyer walking away from the game. He vowed to change. So far, so good.
I think I became an extremist and a profession where that happens to a lot of people. So what am I changing? What's changing is when I shut it off, I'm shutting it off.
Well, I'll tell you one thing he's changed. He's really done a good job of staying in shape.
Off season, hour a day. In season, you shoot to 45 minutes a day. Turn to cardio for 30 and then core or left. That's what I'm doing. But you have a fine time, man. I'll learn that lesson. People that we have to motivate are 18 to 22 years old. Coach Mick is different than most.
Let's go!
We had to have him.
Coach Mick,
he's probably the craziest guy that I've ever met in my life.
Man, I tell you where to go. Get your ass over here. I'm running this.
Like a little ball of juice.
He yells when he don't need to yell.
Right over here, let's go!
Always hyper, screaming.
Get him on a platform!
Weight session with Coach Roddy. When we in the weight room, intense, man.
What are they doing? Opposite arm, opposite leg.
We're being soft.
Tommy, that's awful. Do a cut, Tommy.
When Coach Moratti came here, he changed everything.
2 sets each arm.
He gets you stronger, gets you faster.
Butt down, back flat, shoulders back, do it right.
He's really pushing you to be the best player you can be.
Go!
Well, today is practice number 6 and 7. You're starting to feel it. And those non-competitors start to move to the back of the room, the competitors move to the front of the room. The challenge has been the drawing in the sand. We'll see who answers the bell. Here we go, time to go. It's a big day today in the program. For 2012, let's get something done today. What a great day, man, wow. Energy, good. Unbelievable, isn't it? We get to do this.
Somebody's gonna show up today. Somebody's gonna put something on film today.
You stand out like a sore thumb if you're not a competitor. That's the way it is, that's the way it's always gonna be. We're gonna go with the circle. We got a whole bunch of cats watching. Are you a competitor or not? The guy's a dude, man. The guy's a dude.
As 2-a-days begin, there is no shortage of big hits and short tempers.
One's up, one's up. One's up, we got us one. Oh. Might could be a pit bull on a leash right now. This play's gotta work. Take the quarterback. That's good work. You graded a minus. You didn't get him. You didn't get him. That's how hard it is. That's a grown-ass man block. Get a better look, too. Be a badass. If two guys got something going on, that's part of ball. Some punk coming off the sideline running on the field, you're out of here. Is that clear? Everybody good? You got two guys go. That's part of the game. Appreciate the effort. Let's go. You're a different dude right now, 34. You're a different dude.
Whoa! I got you, Carlos. Whoa! You gotta do it again, because you didn't score. Ready, set.
I knew you were gonna do that to me.
Yeah!
I knew you were gonna do that. You aimed right for my ass.
Explode, go into the backfield. No, Chris, don't drop. Don't drop, just right here. What's it called? 70 what? No, it was Shark. You got the f***ing lights on you. And you're f***ing closing your eyes.
This is evaluation time. Okay, I'm looking right at you. I know you're a nice kid. I know you bench press and all that other stuff. You are now officially being evaluated. You got me? Get it done, boy. Get it done. Hey, we're playing this. Hey, we're playing this like fourth downs. Winner take all. Ball in the yard and a half. Last play of the day. Go, hit it. Go. Go, hurry up. Go. Bring it up, let's go, bring it up. At some point, an individual battle, the other guy says deep down, I don't want to go anymore. I've had enough. Same thing with a team. At some point, that team says, you know, wait a minute. That's too much for us to handle. That's called tapping out. We will never see this here. You know what you see on TV sometimes says, when a guy says, I'm tired, I've had enough. You do that, you keep walking. Like walking off our bench. Walking, get out. We determine when the team taps out. That's a culture. That's a mindset. That's the way you're trained from January. You determine that by how hard you go. Not by your mouth, not by after the whistle taking a swing at a guy, but just nonstop, boom, 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 and you're going after someone. I love saying this. That was an Ohio State football practice right there. I'm gonna go on record there, coaches. That was a football practice. We appreciate what you did today. You deserve to go get some rest. We'll see you this afternoon.
Go, break it down, hurry up, go.
And we're on three. One, two, three.
The player's reward for an Ohio State practice is an Ohio State air mattress and nap time.
Coach Meyer and Coach Mick said they don't believe in people going home in between practices during day, so they blew up, I don't know, probably 70, 75 air mattresses.
Just drag them out, and I think the smartest guys will take them to the coldest places in the building and just set them down and, you know, pass out.
These are just not meant to fit through doors.
Guys have to fight it for and go find, you know, nice places to sleep, which is, you know, not ideal.
Team bonding. You're not bonding with me right now.
I want premium place on time, plus I want them all around each other. And you never know, you might develop some great relationships, you might develop some incredible chemistry, and if you do, then watch out.
The Buckeyes aren't going far for today's afternoon practice. A different field, but the same expectations.
Grab me, I want to look in your eyes real fast. Let's go, gotta roll. Everything I've asked so far, you've done, right? I'm asking you to follow up a good one with another good one. I bordered on great this morning. Let's follow up with another one. I don't want to let down. The sign of a good football team is no letdown after something good happens, right? Some good shit's gonna happen this fall. We're no way gonna follow up with a letdown. That's not gonna happen. I'm gonna repeat, some good shit will happen this fall. Some real good stuff. After some good stuff happens, you can't allow a letdown. And you can learn that right now. Hey, quarterback, break him down. Get him going. Go, hurry up, go, hurry up.
One, two, three.
All right.
You go to this drill work right now, and you put the hammer down.
We're going 10 minutes as hard as we possibly go. Nice job, wide outs. That's outstanding. Outstanding. Oh, here we go, man. Here we go. Battle time. Battle royale. Getting reps, man. He's getting reps. Hey, that's a lot of movement. Remember Peyton Manning? It's just this. That a boy. What the hell's that? Braxton, what do you got? Win the game now. You need to make a play for us. You gotta make a play for it. That's it, that's it. That's it, that's it. Good. Finish, finish, finish.
Bring it up, let's go, bring it up, hurry up. Everybody go see your group real fast, your coach, for 10 seconds. Get the old guys out of here. Go back, get cleaned up, go eat dinner, and we'll have a team meeting I'll announce later on. Fino, break it down, go hurry up, let's go hurry up.
1, 2, 3, 10. With the first two-a-day session complete, it's time to do the Dougie.
It'll be all scrimmage. We'll go out, warm up a little bit, and then let them go play. You're gonna identify the depth chart after today. We get a team ready to go play a game. So this will be the last day that we work against, really against each other. But it's getting, it's at the 11th hour, you know, where you have to make some noise some way, whether you're a true freshman that just got here or you've been a guy for a while.
It comes down to 2 hours. It's gonna make or break you. How good you do in these 2 hours is gonna determine if you're gonna play this upcoming season or not.
Winning those scrimmages mean everything. There's definitely a lot of pride on the line, especially in Coach Meyer's eyes.
A lot of newcomers came in here and might earn some spots. If you're a player that's gonna get bypassed, it's tough. When your family and everybody comes down here and they're not playing, everybody wants to know why. Because someone beat you out.
Last night, Coach Meyer, you know, let guys know that this scrimmage was going to define their 2012 season.
Hard to believe, less than 3 weeks, man, we go. 107,000, what a pretty good product on the field. Imagine all those seats will be filled up. There we go. Let's get a first down today. After yesterday morning's practice, they're a little sore. Well, as a health of practice, we got to have a good scrimmage today. You got to keep pushing. I mean, part of you says, okay, let's back off, can't back off. We're going as hard as we can. They got light at the end of the tunnel. Gotta go. I expect to treat this like a game. We're gonna put the ball down and go play. I coach enough football to understand what this afternoon means to you. Come on and give me 2 hours, everything you got.
Have fun with it, right? This is what you do, right? You love to play football.
It's all about having a little bit of guts. You run through your man, you knock your man down. You set the tone for the season today.
Let's
right
go.
Now, right here. To the house on two. 1, 2.
To the house.
Two. Let's go.
Well, we got to go today, man.
We got to go.
What kind of club we got?
Players show up on game day. There ain't no hiding out there today.
Bullets on three. 1, 2, 3. Take the field. Let's go. Take it. Run.
Here come the bullets.
Are these guys afraid? Hey, 14. Bang him, 14. Bang him. Don't put your hands on your knees. Thought they were in shape. What we do this summer? That's a little bouncer step.
Oh, my gosh.
Gosh, darn it!
You know, as positive and negatives like every first scrimmage. Offensively, I still have a little bit of concern just about our passing attack. That's bad, man. It's bad. It's about as bad as I've ever seen. Just pitch the ball, man. Pitch the ball. Pitch the ball, five. Why didn't you kick the ball? You wanted to make a play? He was there. Come on. You gotta be damn automatic, man.
There's a culture on offense right now that I just feel it, you know, where it's okay if you don't make it. It's okay.
Boy, oh boy. Hard to watch right there. It's embarrassing, boy. That is embarrassing.
I look at a lot of these players and they haven't had a lot of success. Because when they were really good a couple years ago, a lot of these guys weren't playing.
Mike, if you want out, just say I want out. I don't want to play football. You're out. You're not going to play in 2 weeks either. Get out, Mike.
We in here, man.
That's a lesson you have to learn right now. Just not there, burn it. Live to see another day.
We just have a culture of accepting, not making it. That two-minute drill is a perfect example. I saw the guy's wide open, and Braxton's going to deliver the ball, and the ball gets tipped out of his hand, and there's not much of a reaction as opposed to we failed there.
Last play. Last play. It's you. You're going to run bench option to win the football game.
If it's over, we win if we pull down that catch. Wow. Just lost the game.
That's the work to do, huh?
To have an efficient passing attack, which we want to have, it's real hard, but we're not as far off as we were. In the first 8 days of practice, I got to witness one of the best practices I've ever seen. I hope they were angry. I want fast, I want hungry and nasty football team, and we'll unleash that on September 1st.
High-quality H2O.
Is that your girlfriend?
Hey, had a way to go! You gotta get the gym!
Bueller? Bueller? You might know what movie that's from?
One of the funniest things I've ever seen.
Corey, ugly as hell, Lindsley.
See this guy right here? Go get him in Ohio State. You don't wear blue out here. Go, 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 go.